In this tutorial, you will learn how to set a distance between two objects and how to activate the dimensions and detect collisions. To move objects, you can directly move them in the scene. But if you want to pose a machine in front of a building, you better use the distance tool. To activate the tool, click the button in the menu. Afterwards, select the snap point of the fixed base. That's the object that should remain in place. Now connect it with the moving point. That's a snap point, part of the object you want to move. The icons help you to identify which of the objects will be moved or stay in place. The crane center, the slewing point, is indicated in red as it's the most relevant point of the machine. For instance, the radius of the hook is defined to that point. Let's select the building and the crane. You see the three dimensions in X, Y, and Z axis. As the crane can't be moved in the Z axis, only the blue and red axis can be defined. Please be aware that the coordinate system is according to the fixed base point. Whenever you rotate this object, the distance axis will rotate as well. Now I will set a distance of 10 meters and the crane will be moved 10 meters away from the building according to the slewing point. You can set a new distance by clicking on this icon. And afterwards, you can define a new base and moving point. To activate the standard dimensions, you have to select an object or a machine, like the LTM1750, and open the Dimensions tab in the Parameter panel. Here you can activate one or several standard dimensions, and they will be indicated in the scene and reports. I select the outreach or radius and the main boom angle dimension. And you see the dimension instantly indicated in the scene. A custom dimension can be defined by clicking on the icon Add Custom Dimension. Afterwards, all snap points in the scene are indicated with small orange dots. Whenever you come closer, the dots get bigger. Let's measure the distance from the corner of the building to the outrigger. Therefore, we connect those two points and afterwards, you see the dimension in the scene. As this dimension is defined in 3D, you might be interested only in two or one of those dimensions. To reduce the dimensions, select the custom dimension in the object panel and open the parameter panel. Select project onto and the XY plane and the dimension will be projected onto the ground. The projected dimension is now shown in the scene and will be included in the report as well. A collision will be detected between the machine and any object such as the buildings and the load objects. Collisions are also detected between load objects and any other objects. Let's move the machine into the building. As soon as you post an object into the new position, the collision will be indicated in a red blinking bubble surrounding the collision point. If you zoom out, you will see a warning sign that can be seen from all perspectives in the scene. In this tutorial, we learned how to use the distance tool to activate and set dimensions and get familiar with the collision detection. In the next tutorial, you will get familiar with the snapshots and the renderings.